Hello, guys. I hope everyone is having a good time. I'm Sunil Maya. I'm doing my master's at TU Kaiserslautern. Previously, I worked for Nokia Networks. Today, I'm going to present a project which I did with open source organization KEA as a part of Google Summer of Code. The title, as it says, Faster IPv6 Renumbering. So let's consider scenarios where we need to renumber IPv6 networks. So what are those scenarios? Those scenarios are your enterprise network switches to a new service provider. In those cases, all the clients, all the routers system which are using your older service providers need to migrate to the newer ones. So in that, those cases, we need to reconfigure or renumber each of these IPv6 addresses. The challenges include that during these migrations, we don't cause abruption to have minimum abruption and minimum downtime. Second case where we need to renumber our IPv6 networks include where your top-level network topology is switched from one location to the other. In those cases, we need to migrate those IPv6 addresses below. That is another case of your renumbering of your IPv6 network. And the third case is when you're internally you reorganize your network topologies. You might have new links adding up to support different features for load balancing. In all those cases, whenever there's a change of network elements and change your internal topology, we need to reconfigure your network. So having discussed a small motivation of why we need renumbering, let's move on to the existing methodologies which are available in the existing methods which we need to use for renumbering. The most popular ones with renumbering includes renumbering with a flag day. As we know, flag day is a predefined date and time where the operator announces that there's going to be a downtime, and he shuts down the entire network, assigns the new configuration for the entire network, and brings up the network again. This is popular, but the main downside to this is that if your network elements need continuous services, those are blocked, and those are not always desired. But this continues to be one of the popular methods. The second period, second method of renumbering your network is a transition period-based renumbering. How that happens is each of the clients, each of the DHCP clients, as to renew their leases, always send either a renew or reband request periodically after the expiry of T1 or T2 timers. During that period, what usually happens is if a new IP address needs to be assigned, always the server side could trigger by reducing the lifetimes of the older IP addresses and assigning the new IP addresses in the reply messages. So this is one traditional method which is also deployed. The advantage of this is that there is no downtime required, and there is a smooth transitioning. But the main disadvantage of such a thing, such a method, is that it is not completely under the operator's control. For example, if the operator wants to suddenly deploy a new IPv6 address instantaneously to all its clients, it has to wait till each and every DHCP client sends a renew or a reband message. Hence, there are downsides to it. Now, the third method, which we are going to discuss now, and which was the part of the project which I'd done with KEA, was network-initiated renumbering. With network-initiated renumbering, this is a mechanism in which the DHCPv6 server triggers for reconfiguration. So it is a server-initiated message exchange where clients are forced to send a reconfigure forced to send a renew or rebind message, and the server could change the IP addresses dynamically. So it takes the disadvantages of both, and it tries to work on that. For example, you don't have a flag time. You don't have a flag day defined for this. So you don't have a downtime. You have a smooth transition. Plus, it is instantaneously. So the operator doesn't have to wait for a certain interval or for each of the clients to send the message. Now let's discuss how this network-initiated reconfigure message works. As we discussed, it's a faster way to renumber a network. It is a server-triggered message. And when the server sends a reconfigure message, it sends an option for the client to send either a renew or a rebind request. thereby forcing the client to update its IP addresses. Along with this, this reconfigure message also includes a security protocol so that your rogue, there might be rogue servers in the network which might be, which might try to assign a wrong IP addresses to the clients. To prevent that, we have a remote key authentication protocol included in this reconfigure message. And the detailed work mechanism can be referred in RFC 3315. Now, let's see what are the message exchanges which happens with a reconfigure message. Let's start with the initial IPv6 address assignment, where your client sends a solicit, your server advertises, then you send the client request for an IP address, and the server replies with the grant and assigns leases in the, its backend, and the, it goes on. So your client has a new IPv6 address associated with it. Now, let's see your T1, T2 timer expires. The client triggers us a renew or rebind based on which timer has expired. And let's see, and after that, let's say assume this is the normal operation. Later point of time, let's say the network address has been updated, and now the server or the administrator wants to reconfigure the network. So during that time, he will just initiate a reconfigure message. And as a reply to this reconfigure message, your client sends either a renew or a rebind option for the older addresses. As a reply, the server triggers a reply, including where he reduces the lifetime of the older IPv6 address and assigns a new IPv6 addresses. So as we know, we have a preferred lifetime and a valid lifetime for IPv6 addresses. So by assigning different lifetime addresses, there's a smooth older applications which were using the older IPv6 addresses continue to use that, and newer applications will be started with a new IPv6 addresses. Now let's also discuss the remote key authentication protocol to prevent the rogue servers from sending an unwanted reconfigure message. So the idea here is that the server, as we can see here, whenever a server tries to assign IP addresses via reply message, it also sends an authentication key to the client. Now, this authentication key is per client. The client stores this authentication key. Next, whenever the server wants to send a reconfigure message to the same client, it sends a checksum with the previously exchanged key, and the client validates the whole message with this checksum with its previously stored key. And hence, there is no way a rogue DHCP server could send false IPv6 addresses to the client. Next, regarding the project, I did this as a part of my student project for Google Summer of Code and for the open source organization ISE KEA. KEA is an open source organization. It's implemented completely using modern C++. It has high performance, it supports online configuration, and it also supports multiple configuration database backends for storing the leases as a configuration. So currently, it stores MySQL, PostgreSQL, and Cassandra database, also with a normal file-based storage. So renumbering with KEA. So talking now, discuss the mechanism, how an operator should actually reconfigure. Basically, the operator first configures the keys for the client, and it is distributed. Then the administrator updates the configuration with the new IPv6 addresses, and he just sends the command to all the clients. Yes, so that is the overall mechanism what we have implemented. The current status of the project is currently no commercially available DHCP servers support reconfiguration. But with this, we hope everybody, all the clients start supporting it. So we are targeting it to release at 1.6. That's it. I thank Dino for providing me this opportunity to speak. Thank you.
Thank you, Sunil. We have time for one or two very, very short questions. Benedict.
Thank you. Benedict Stockerbrand, Stepladder IT. Just four comments. First one is, if you do this sort of renumbering, it doesn't work with servers which you have statically configured like most people use. So you have a problem that you have to sort out the situation. You can't just renumber everything through DHCP. Second problem involved there are Android devices, which don't support DHCPv6. Third problem is you do that and you'll have a lot of fun with your first level support because TCP doesn't support this either. It means all existing connections will... What, Lutz? Okay. And last one is another thing that doesn't really support this sort of fast renumbering is DNS. So if you have servers in the DNS and the DNS entries get cached, it will take time until the new addresses actually make it to the DNS caches possibly involved. So you really want to be careful with this sort of renumbering. So there's some really serious limitations on that. Thank you.
Thank you. I don't think those are questions. Those are directly the facts. Which I agree with. The project was actually focused on only few of the use cases of renumbering feature and implementing those. Of course, it only is for IPv6, it's not for V4, and only those specific domains. So I take all those comments, and definitely we can discuss offline on how further. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you, Sunil.
Thank you all.
Next one up is Lutz.